Hello, this is the first episode of a tutorial series on ngSpice. So in this episode, I'll just give a brief introduction on ngSpice and how we can simulate a simple circuit using ngSpice. So if you go through its website, ngSpice, you will find this information. It is a open source Spice simulator. And you can simulate almost any circuit, electrical and electronic circuits, using this tool. And it does not come with a schematic editor. Actually, to simulate any circuit, you don't need a fancy GUI based schematic editor. You need only just a text editor and command prompt. Enough. You can run this code and you can see the output and you can analyze the circuit. So this is a typical output prompt, and here it, you can see here all the coding of this circuit, and it's a command prompt. So you write a code for the circuit, from the command prompt you run that, so you will get this output. Okay, so we'll see now how we can code a circuit. So I will take a simple example, and before that I will just show you the typical structure of a code. For example, if you take any circuit, it will have these components. First one, you can write title of the code, then you mention all the power supplies or excitation signal which you are going to use, and include the model file path. Suppose if you are using a particular BJT or a particular diode, you can add its parameters through a model file. So that also you can add. Then statements explaining the interconnection of components. First of all, you have to number all the nodes, then you have to explain each component and its location. So that is the statement explaining interconnection of components. Next one is subcircuit. If you have any subcircuit, you can add that, that is an optional. Then control statement. So far what we have done, we are explaining the components. This control statement, we will write the action we want to do. What are the actions? It may be a DC operating point, or it may be a AC sweep, DC sweep. So all those actions we will store in this block, control statement. And finally, end statement. Okay. So we will take one example, simple example, and then we will see how. Let us take one simple circuit, which consists of a resistor and capacitor and a AC source. It is a low pass first order RC circuit, and let us write code for this from the beginning. So first part is, so this, as I mentioned earlier, it will have these components. In that, some are optional, but typical code will have these components. First you have to number the node. So we have three nodes here. This is node 1, node 2, and ground or earth. By default it is ground, node 0. So first line of the program is title of the code. So whatever you write in the first line, that is considered to be a comment, and it is the title of the circuit. So we'll write that this is the first circuit. And you can use any text editor. I am using a text editor called a LeafPad, but you can use a notepad or any simple text editor which is available in your operating system, that you can use. So since I am using Linux, I am using LeafPad here. So first line is nothing but a comment, that is, I am writing it as this is the first circuit, that is a comment of the, or it is a title of the code. Next one, the part 2 is power supplies and excitation signals. Here we have this power signal, that is this excitation signal, that is nothing but an AC source. So any voltage source you want to name it, it must start with V. So I will start with V. After that you give whatever name you want. So here it is given like V in, so we'll give V in. Next we'll write the location of the source, so where it is lying. So this particular AC source is in between node 1 and node 0, so that we'll write 1 space 0. Next you write what is the type of the signal, whether it is a DC, AC, sinusoidal, pulse. So in this example we'll consider only the AC signal. So we'll mention in that DC value is 0 and AC value is 1. So it is AC source with amplitude 1. And you can see the NGSpice manual how to specify a sinusoidal excitation signal or a pulse. So in this problem we'll concentrate only on the AC source. Okay. So that is the only power source we have here, so that we have mentioned. Third one, it says include the model file path. So in this circuit we don't need any model file, that is required only if you are using a transistor, a diode, MOSFET. So here we are not using any such devices, we don't need a model file here. And fourth part is statements explaining the interconnection of components. So apart from voltage source we have a resistor, we have a capacitor, so that we have to write. Resistor should always start with R, its name always should start with R, so we'll write R. It need not be a capital R, you can use small r also. And number of you have to give other, if you want to, there are two resistor, you can write one resistor as R1, another one is R2. So in this one we have only one resistor, I will write R1. Whatever name you want to give, you can give, but it should start with R. So R1, and it lies between node 1 and 2. Node 1 space 2 and its value. So value is 1000, or you can write 1K also. So NGSpice recognizes certain units, that is K means kilo, capital G means giga, U means micro, MEG means mega, and you don't write ohm or any unit later, you just write 1K enough, don't write 1 kilo ohm. So whenever it is resistor, it is understood it is in ohms. Okay. So next one is the capacitor, it should start with the letter C. And after that, whatever name you want to give, you can give. I will give C1 here. And it lies between 2 and 0. And its value is 1 micro. So I'll write 1U. So we have complete all the components. Now next one is subcircuit description. Here we are not using any subcircuit, so we don't need this part. Next one is the control statement. So we'll write what are the analysis or operation we would like to perform in this block. So we'll write dot control. So it should start with this statement, dot control, and it should end with dot end C. So in between we can add any analysis or operation you would like to perform, any plotting or saving, anything you have to put within this. So in this we would like to perform frequency response, we would like to analyze the frequency response. So I have to perform a AC sweep. So for that syntax is, first you mention AC, and scale you mention whether it's a linear, logarithmic, or certain points you want to plot. So I would like to choose logarithmic, so I will write DEC. DEC means decade scale. Next one is the number of points per decade. So you would like to plot how many points per decade. So I would like to consider 100 points per decade. You can have 10, 20, whatever number you wish. Next one is the starting frequency, that is 1 hertz I will start, and end frequency. Let us take 100 kilo. So this is syntax AC, DEC, 100, 1 to 100K. What does it mean? Perform AC analysis in logarithmic scale and consider 100 points per decade, and you start from frequency 1 and sweep till 100 kilo. And after that, we would like to plot the output. So if you write plot V of 2, so that means it will plot voltage at node 2 with respect to the frequency from 1 to 100k and frequency sweep in decade scale. But usually in Bode plot, we consider 20 log of voltage at a particular point. So that we can simply write, instead of writing 20 into log of V of 2, we can write dB of V of 2. So this will automatically plot 20 into logarithmic of voltage at node 2. So this is what we would like to perform. So we will write this. One is perform AC analysis and plot. After the end C, that is, you have to terminate this control block. And then last statement is the end statement. So that is dot END. So this is the code for this circuit. Now we will save it. I will save in the home folder. So, and extension, you can give either SCIR or NET or SPI. I will use dot NET. So save. Now let us go to that folder where it is stored. And in my case, it is a home folder. So you can see here eg1.net. Now you simply write ng spice space name of the file, that is eg1.net. You can see that first in the command prompt, it will give these statements. Title of the code, we have written, this is the title, this is the first circuit. So this is the title of the code, and it will see at what temperature it is carrying the analysis, and number of data rows, how many points, 100 points per decade we have mentioned. So totally 501 points it has considered and plotted accordingly. Now you can see it is a low pass circuit response. We can see that it is a low pass filter with cutoff frequency 1 by 2 pi RC. So if you calculate R equal to 1K capacitor 1 micro, it will come around 150 or 154, around 154 you will get. So now also you can, if you want to see the value at a particular point, you just click on that point. So I am clicking on this one around minus 3 dB, just left click. So you can see that that node value is given in the command prompt. What is that? X naught is 173 and Y naught is minus. So around minus 3 dB it is showing 173. So it should come 150. I have not taken exactly at minus 3 dB. At minus 3 dB it will be around 156, like that it will come. So from this we can easily analyze a circuit and understand it in a better way. And if you want to take any hard copy, just you press on hard copy here. So you will get a message like this, where it is stored. So in this case, it is stored in temporary folder. So there you can take the copy of that, and you can take print out also that. Okay. So this is about the first example using ngSpice. Thank you.